It is time for Informed Sources right here on News Channel 3, where the Mid-South's smartest viewers go to get the real story behind the big stories. I'm Richard Ransom. Thanks for joining us. We really appreciate you being here, and I'm going to introduce you to my panel this week in a moment. But first, let's show you tonight's topics. Corporate inauguration. The list of companies that contributed to President Trump's inauguration celebration was made public this week. We're going to talk about some local names that we found on the list. Gas tax approved. For a while, it seemed like Tennessee Governor Bill Haslam's proposal to increase the gas tax was on life support. But this week, it won easy passage. So what happened? But first, our hot topic tonight, Beale Street Bucks are back. That's the name for a program that imposes a cover fee just to get on the street. The idea of it rubs some people the wrong way, but supporters say this program works and keeps the troublemakers away. What does my panel think about that? Before we can talk about it, I have to introduce my very good-looking panel we have assembled here tonight. Jackson Baker is the political writer for the Memphis Flyer. We have former Memphis City Councilwoman Wanda Halbert and also former Memphis City School Board member Reverend Kenneth Whalen Jr. Thanks to all three of you for being here. Can't wait to talk about this Beale Street Bucks program, because I hear just a lot of negative about it. I don't hear a lot of support, but you cannot argue the contention of the Downtown Commission that it works and seems to keep people who are going to cause some trouble on the street away. But there's the whole court issue that we know is before a federal court right now, and the lawsuit that says it's unconstitutional to ban someone from a public street unless they pay to get on. What are your thoughts, Jackson?
Well, you know, it's one of those things. What is Beale Street? Is it an entertainment district, or is it a public street? It is both. And obviously, you're being charged because it's an entertainment district. You're being charged your $10 to go in there. It is a public street, and that is just sort of a problem. It's always been with Beale Street. Really, there are two groups that control Beale Street. There's the Merchants Association, which is really developed this Bucks thing. And there's various agencies that are supposed to be in control, but one of them just expired.
And now the mayor has his own decisions to make on Beale Street. The whole leadership issue is kind of a vacuum right now.
It's an entertainment district. It's almost like entering a building.
So let's show folks, Wanda, before we get your take on this, exactly what is involved with this. The Beale Street Bucks program involves people paying a $10 cover fee to enter the street. Now, this time around, $8 of that is refunded via a voucher. So people can spend, it really only costs $2 to get on, is the argument, because they can use that $8 at any of the establishments on Beale Street. The Downtown Commission is very quick to point out that this is only charged after 10 p.m. So it's free to get on Beale Street up until 10 o'clock, and this is only on nights when there's a lot of traffic, like Saturday nights. Does that change your view on it?
No, it doesn't change my view. As a matter of fact, I think what's sad about it is the street belongs to the citizens of Memphis. It belongs to Memphis, Tennessee. And it doesn't matter what we're using the street for, it belongs to the people. The second issue that I take with it is, think about what you just recited. What are you really charging the money for? Because you're claiming that it's to try to help keep those who you don't necessarily want on the street somewhat away, but then you turn around and give them the voucher, which you have to pay to go into the facilities or the establishments, a lot of the establishments anyway. So what is your real purpose of charging the money? And, you know, I personally believe that it is unconstitutional. It is a public street, even though it's an entertainment district. And a lot of individuals always talk about Bourbon Street. Now, you know, what street is bigger than Bourbon Street? And do you have to pay to get on Bourbon Street? I think I would hope the mayor and the city council take a better look at this and make some different decisions. If you're trying to control the crowd, figure out how to do that in a different way other than assessing a charge that seems to have some questionable motives.
Reverend Whalen, I don't visit Beale Street like I used to in my younger years, but the most recent time that I did was last year, and they were assessing this Beale Street Bucks program that night, and I thought just how unfortunate and how much things have changed over time. You know, if I'm a tourist, I was thinking, and I'm visiting Beale Street for the first time from Chicago or someplace, and I see what appears to be a high security, almost, you know, Fort Knox type situation, it didn't seem very welcoming to me.
Well, the reason I and Sheila don't go as much as we used to is for the very reason that the fee is being implemented. It's not safe. And the elephant on the curb is the fact that the association claims that it works. What that means is that the fee is directed toward black, poor, an element that if you look at the police statistics, you'll see who's the most arrested, who's most involved in the crime. It's just a very serious problem that goes even deeper than that, because now we're talking about a form of terrorism. We just saw the shootings at the Champs-Élysées in Paris. So it's not a racial thing in that sense, except that if we don't do a better job of producing productive citizens, no amount of money, no amount of cover charge is going to protect us. What happens when you walk away from the street to go to your car and you're robbed or assaulted? We've got a very serious problem in Memphis, and no cover charge is going to correct it.
Rich, I have another thought, too. This is somewhat a justification of there being a surcharge. Let's face it, Beale Street is something of a Potemkin village. That's the name given to those Russian villages in the first years of the Soviet era that were mock villages, had false fronts. Beale Street has false fronts. It isn't a street in the usual sense. All those edifices are there as part of an apparatus that is an entertainment district. And I think you can almost justify that, like going to the Mid-South Fair. You have to pay to go to the Mid-South Fair. It's got structures that exist for that purpose, too.
One thing you guys reported on recently was that the street is looking for leadership. Well, after decades of black political leadership, you mean to tell me nobody has come up with a way to make the street so important and so meaningful to everybody in the city, rich, poor, black, and white, that nobody would dare go down there and commit a crime after decades of black political leadership? That's the elephant on the curb. We better do something.
Well, you're talking about a couple of big elephants here, Wanda. Yeah. Let me get you to weigh in on that. First of all, let's hear from Terrence Patterson. He's the president and CEO of the Downtown Memphis Commission, and he was responding to a criticism of why did we keep moving up the date that this cover fee is charged. And he said, we have a quote here, after evaluation, the program last year, and thinking about historical events, I felt we should start this program at the beginning of the season, and that is in mid-April. He also added, and I think this is interesting, he really doesn't like doing this either. He said, it's my hope in the future that we don't have to do this. But when you hear what Reverend Whalen is saying, it sounds like bigger societal programs need to be addressed that the Downtown Memphis Commission isn't going to take on.
And therein lies the issue. It appears that there's something else that's really driving this decision. And whatever it is, just be honest with the citizens of Memphis, whether it's crime, whether it's poor, whether black people, whatever the reason is, put the reason on the table so that we can have an open and honest discussion about it. And I agree with Reverend Whalen. Why is the leadership not addressing the holistic issue of what this is about? Something is awry here, and simply putting a cover charge in place is not going to resolve it.
It's covering up the problem.
At least $8 back is better than $7 back, which is what you got last year.
That's right. They have to buy a dollar. Very, very true. Well, one last thought on this came from the Commercial Appeal and an editorial about it. And they said, it's not the welcome mat we want to send tourists and locals alike who should have the option of merely doing people watching on what is essentially downtown's entertainment front porch. And it goes to my point earlier. What is the impression we're giving folks who are visiting Memphis for the first time?
Absolutely.
And I tell you what, there are a lot of people who visit Beale Street from all over the world. You don't realize it necessarily until you're down there and see for yourself.